Hello, everyone. My name is John Jarcho. I'm a cardiologist and a deputy editor at the New England Journal of Medicine. I'm very happy to be with you here today on the floor of the American Heart Association Scientific Sessions to talk with you a little bit about some of the papers that we're publishing in conjunction with the meeting. One clinical trial that has certainly attracted a lot of attention here at the meeting is the REDUCE-IT trial. There have been a number of trials in the past of various preparations of omega-3 fatty acids for the reduction of cardiovascular events. Most of those trials have not shown a significant benefit of such agents. However, there was one recent trial, the JELIS trial, which showed significant cardiovascular event reduction, in particular with eicosapentaenoic acid, which is one of the omega-3 fatty acids. And that trial helped to provide part of the rationale for the REDUCE-IT trial. In REDUCE-IT, a highly purified ethyl ester of eicosapentaenoic acid, called eicosapent ethyl, was compared to placebo in 8,000 patients who had either established cardiovascular disease or diabetes mellitus plus at least one other cardiovascular risk factor. The dose of eicosapent ethyl that was used in the trial was 4 grams daily, which is a considerably larger dose than in most omega-3 fatty acid trials in the past. The primary endpoint of the trial was a composite of cardiovascular death, myocardial infarction, stroke, coronary revascularization, and unstable angina. At a median of 5 years of follow-up, there was a significant reduction in this primary endpoint with eicosapent ethyl. It is not entirely clear how eicosapent ethyl produced this effect on cardiovascular outcomes. There was a significant reduction in serum triglyceride levels with the study drug. However, the benefit on cardiovascular outcomes did not correlate with either baseline triglyceride levels or the reduction in triglyceride levels. A second trial for which we published the paper yesterday is the DECLARE-TIMI-58 trial. This was a trial of the drug dapagliflozin versus placebo in patients with diabetes. Dapagliflozin is a selective inhibitor of the sodium glucose cotransporter 2, or SGLT2. And this was actually the third trial of an agent in the SGLT2 class for cardiovascular outcomes, following empagliflozin in the EMPA-REG outcome trial and canagliflozin in the CANVAS trial. Drugs in the SGLT2 inhibitor class reduce hyperglycemia in patients with type 2 diabetes mellitus by decreasing renal glucose absorption. In EMPA-REG outcome and CANVAS, there was a significant benefit on cardiovascular outcomes with the SGLT2 inhibitor. In the DECLARE trial, dapagliflozin was compared to placebo in 17,000 patients who had diabetes mellitus and either known cardiovascular disease or multiple cardiovascular risk factors. The primary outcome of the trial was a composite of cardiovascular death, myocardial infarction, or stroke. Dapagliflozin compared to placebo was non-inferior for this primary trial outcome. However, it was not statistically superior. But there was a benefit with regard to an important secondary outcome, the composite of cardiovascular death or hospitalization for heart failure. This benefit was primarily due to a reduction in hospitalization for heart failure. The results of the DECLARE trial may help cardiologists to become more comfortable with prescribing SGLT2 inhibitors for their patients with diabetes. Recent evidence suggests that despite the available trial evidence, most cardiologists are not comfortable prescribing these drugs, and the use of these drugs is relatively low in cardiovascular practice. The final study that I'd like to talk to you about today is called the PIONEER-HF trial. This is a very interesting trial of the drug Tsukubitril Valsartan in patients with acute decompensated heart failure. Tsukubitril Valsartan is a combination drug with two potentially beneficial effects. Valsartan is an angiotensin receptor blocker, and Tsukubitril is a neprilysin inhibitor, which blocks the metabolic breakdown of natriuretic peptides. In a previous large randomized trial called Paradigm-HF, Tsukubitril Valsartan, when compared to the ACE inhibitor enalapril, was found to significantly reduce the outcome of cardiovascular death or hospitalization for heart failure in patients with heart failure. Paradigm was a very important trial, but it did have the limitation that patients were required to be very stable clinically before they could be randomized. The trial required that all patients tolerate a dose of enalapril of at least 10 milligrams daily or a comparable dose of another ACE inhibitor or ARB. Then it required that patients enter an open label phase with enalapril when they had to tolerate this drug and patients with adverse events were excluded. And finally, patients had to enter an open label phase with Tsukubitril Valsartan and again had to tolerate this drug before they could go on to randomization. Therefore, the population in Paradigm-HF, while in general representative of patients with heart failure, was selective for those that were quite stable and excluded many of the patients who were originally considered for randomization. Therefore, the Pioneer-HF trial was designed to try to evaluate whether Tsukubitril Valsartan could be initiated in a population of patients who were much less stable than those seen in Paradigm-HF, particularly patients who were hospitalized with acute decompensated heart failure, a group that had specifically been excluded from the Paradigm trial. In Pioneer-HF, the comparator to Tsukubitril Valsartan, as in Paradigm, was enalapril. 881 patients were enrolled and randomized. The primary outcome was the reduction in N-terminal pro-BNP levels at 8 weeks. And indeed, in this trial, there was a greater reduction in N-terminal pro-BNP levels at 8 weeks with Tsukubitril Valsartan than with enalapril. However, perhaps at least as interesting, if not more interesting, than these primary outcome results were the results with regard to safety in this trial. There was no significant difference between the two groups with regard to rates of symptomatic hypotension, hyperkalemia, worsening renal function, or angioedema. These data thus suggest that, with appropriate precautions, Tsukubitril Valsartan can be safely initiated in patients who have been hospitalized for acute decompensated heart failure. There are a number of other major trials that the New England Journal has published to coincide with the AHA at this meeting, but I think I will stop there. It has been my pleasure to discuss these interesting studies with you. If you'd like to read any of the papers that NEJM has published together with the AHA, let me suggest that you check out the AHA webpage at nejm.org. Thank you very much.